za nyinyi. Kama mko na shida na Wakikuyu, hamuko na shida na Wakikuyu kuliko sisi wa Kalenjin. Tuko na shida kubwa zaidi. Sawa sawa. Lakini ikifika mahali unatofautisha maneno, unaweka maneno ya tofauti za kijamii kando, unatafuta serikali kwanza, kwa sababu ile serikali itakusaidia kutatua matatizo ulio nayo.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome again to the analysis of Fulino TV. I hope you well from wherever you watch this channel. Now I started by showing you a video of William Samoei Ruto. That was before William Samoei Ruto became the president, and he made a statement there. It's a very strong statement, and if you are very keenly listening to that video, the words are self-explanatory, ladies and gentlemen. So also I would like to take you to another video by one Ferdinand Waititu, the former governor of Kiambu County. So I wanted to listen to what Ferdinand Waititu said in an event that was attended by Rigathi Gachagua. So just watch this video.
Sisi tunahusunika sana. Na watu wengi sisi, 100%, tumelose confidence na hii serikali. Sisi tunaregret kuchagua Mheshimiwa William Ruto kama president wetu. Kwa sababu...
Very well, ladies and gentlemen. That is Ferdinand Waititu making a statement there. Those two videos already point to something. I don't know whether what I'm feeling is what you're feeling, but Ferdinand Waititu seems to be regretting voting for William Samoei Ruto. But in the first video, Ruto talked about, you know, joining the Mount Kenya people to maybe form a government. And if you look at what is happening right now, maybe that is what William Ruto did. He coalesced with the Mount Kenya leaders to form a government. Now it is time to now exert authority. Maybe that is the message that is being conveyed. So I want us to go through the old video. The video is around 3 minutes. I don't know whether you've watched it somewhere, but perhaps if you've not watched it, I wish to share the old video so that you can get a better understanding of what I'm trying to mean in this analysis, ladies and gentlemen. So before we get there, please like this video. So important, like this video, because we have something very, very interesting that we need to address. And this is pointing to leaders in Mount Kenya. These leaders, it appears as if they lied to the people of Mount Kenya. Going by what Ferdinand Waititu has said, it is literally what Ferdinand Waititu said. The message is literally trying to expose the leaders in Mount Kenya, the ones that are still part of UDA and the ones that are slowly distancing themselves from the other faction of William Ruto. So like this video, and you can subscribe to our channel if you're not subscribed before to existing subscribers. Thank you so much for your support. So let me share this video. The old video is around 3 minutes. I wish that you can just take some of your time and watch the old clip. Just watch it.
Bwana Deputy President, sisi wewe ndio mkubwa wetu sahi. Na sisi hatutaki kuona ukiwa mistreated ama disrespected. Sisi tunataka upewe heshima, kwa sababu heshima yako inaoneshana heshima ya Mount Kenya region. Ile kitu tunasema, kwa sababu tunajua wale tunapigana nao, tunashindana nao, sio watu wachache. Wengine wao ni wajanja, wengine wao hata ukora wako naye ndani yao. Sisi tunataka kwanza tuungane kama one mountain. Na sisi tunataka tukienda 2027, mwito wa watu wa street, mimi nikiwa kwa street, ni kitu moja. Sisi tukue na candidate mmoja wa kiti ya president, ambaye atanegotiate na wale wengine kama Mheshimiwa Kalonzo Musyoka. Sisi tu hapa nataka kuenda vile tulienda last time. Tukishikana na mtu, lazima kuwe maandishi, tutapata hii na tutapata hii na tutapata hii. Maneno ya kubahatisha tena hatutaki. Point number 2, mimi nikiwa Nairobi, tumesikia aibu kubwa sana kuona watu wetu wamebomolewa manyumba. Watu wengi sana wa Kikuyu, watu wa Mount Kenya, wamebomolewa manyumba yao. ambayo wameishi muda mrefu sana huko Nairobi. Sisi tunahusunika sana. Na watu wengi sisi, 100%, tumelose confidence na hii serikali. Sisi tunaregret kuchagua Mheshimiwa William Ruto kama president wetu. Kwa sababu, yale manyumba ambayo watu wamekuwa naso for 40-30 years, ambayo wako na title, wamekaa pale, wamengolewa kwa manyumba yao, watu wengi sana that have become destitute. Hawana pahali ya kuenda. Na sisi tunasema hivi, Mheshimiwa Kenyatta aliwawacha pale, Moi aliwawacha pale, Mheshimiwa Kibaki aliwawacha pale, Bwana Uhuru aliwawacha pale. Nini hii imeonekana na hii serikali ambayo imekuja kungua watu wetu? Na tumesema hivi, 2027, watu wa Nairobi, sisi na Shindangwa na kura ambayo haijazidi 50,000. Tunataka sisi pale Nairobi, governor wa kwanza, awe ni Mkikuyu, awe ni nani, lakini awe mtu wa Mount Kenya region. Tumepigia wengine kura. Sisi ndio tulisagua chosungu watu wa Mount Kenya. Juzi tulikuwa pale mimi nikiongoza kwa UDA. Tukachagua Sakaja. Saa hii amekukosea heshima wewe, na sisi amekukosea heshima kama Mount Kenya region. Aling'oa watu wetu wote kazini. Tunataka wakati ya 2027 hiyo communities wale wengine waturudishie shukurani. Ona hivyo toshoke lio
ga. Chitu is telling us that he regrets voting for William Ruto. I know there are people who want to say that maybe Waititu is making that statement because he has not been given a job in this Kenya Kwanza government. Same to what the former Bahati Member of Parliament said. The former Bahati Member of Parliament, Ngunjiri, Kimani Ngunjiri, said that he is going to fight the government until he gets a job. So we also know that Kimani Ngunjiri, the reason why he's that mad could be because he was never given a job, or because he's trying to defend Rigathi Gachagua. But on to Ferdinand Waititu's remarks. Of course, we expected that Waititu was going to get an appointment, a parastatal appointment, or maybe a CAS appointment, or maybe, you know, a board of directors somewhere. But Ferdinand Waititu, despite the fact that he fought for the formation of UDA, he fought for the survival of UDA, is one of those people who fought in Mount Kenya. He fought Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta in Mount Kenya, but he has not benefited. So some of the things I make from this video that I've shared regarding Ferdinand Waititu, one of them could be because he has not been given a job by William Ruto. So now he's regretting. Perhaps if Ferdinand Waititu was made a minister, he wouldn't have said so. Maybe Waititu is feeling that, despite the fact that he fought for this regime, people like Kiriati Murungi ended up benefiting. You see, Kiriati Murungi was in Azimio, but the moment he'd come from Azimio, he was given a position by William Ruto. But the people like Ketu Ariguru, Kimani Ngunjiri, people like Ferdinand Waititu have not been given any appointment. They were left to earn from, you know, the wave, you know, to take advantage of the wave and probably get their elective positions. But because they didn't get their elective positions or seats, they have been languishing in cold until now. So the statement that Ferdinand Waititu has made there partly is because he has not been given a job. Partly is because of what is happening in Nairobi. Now there's something he talked about there that talks about demolition of houses for, you know, Kikuyu residents. You know, that is talking about the people from Mount Kenya, that they've been living in Nairobi, in those areas that they've been living in, but this Ruto regime, the Kenya Kwanza government, realized that this need to have them evacuated, or rather to remove from the places they've been living. Waititu talks about Jomo Kenyatta left them there, Moi left them there, Kibaki left them there, Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta left them there. So he's asking, how comes the Kenya Kwanza government is seeing a mistake, is seeing a fault there? What about the four governments? What happened? Did they see these people? I know, and this one I believe, I think you'll agree with me, I know that Ferdinand Waititu today if he's given a job, he might not talk about these things. So these are some of the leaders who are supposed to be blamed. In fact, they're the ones who misled the residents of Mount Kenya to vote in a particular direction. Now they are telling the same residents that they regret. You know, it's I don't know that you're getting my point. The same leaders who misled the people of Mount Kenya are now telling the same people they misled that they regret, you know, campaigning for William Ruto. This, personally, if you ask me, I'll tell you these are the leaders who are supposed to be kicked out from politics forever. In fact, the Gen Zs should punish this kind of leaders. Leaders like Waititu. They can't surface now and purport to defend the people of Mount Kenya. They can't. After making some wrong decisions which are contrary to what Uhuru was saying. You know, this Ferdinand Waititu and the like are the people who used to fight Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. They fought Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta and they labeled Raila Amolo Odinga bad names. So now they are coming out to glorify Raila Amolo Odinga. They are coming out to glorify Uhuru Kenyatta. Led by Rigathi Gachagua, I don't think Mount Kenya people should forgive these leaders. Since they misled, they chose to mislead them, they should carry that blame forever. You know, in fact, if I'm Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta, I should not even give these people a listening ear. These are not people who should even be listened to. You know, for a leader to say that, I regret. So you did not weigh options. So you regret, you didn't weigh options, and you sold Mount Kenya people to the highest bidder. That is what I can make from this statement. And that's what I can make from the actions of the leaders who are now saying they don't trust the Ruto regime, despite the fact that they fought for the Ruto regime. But there's always an exception to everything. Someone like Wamuchomba, I cannot blame Wamuchomba. Wamuchomba has been standing with the people ever since this Kenya Kwanza government took over in parliament. Last year, the first financial bill of this Kenya Kwanza government, Wamuchomba is the first UDA leader to fight it. And she has even fought it in this new finance bill of the Ruto regime again. She fought it. Of course, we saw people like Esther Passaris fight it, Jalango fight it. But I know why Jalango decided to vote a no. It's because he's still a media personality. And because he's a media personality, he's realizing that if at all he had voted a yes, that would have been the end of even his channel, Jalango TV. Or would have been the end of his career. Because people would have used that platform to fight back. So, ladies and gentlemen, this remark by Ferdinand Waititu, I am looking at it from two angles. And I've explained in this analysis why I still believe Ferdinand Waititu is not the right person to try to tell people that they regret. They are not supposed to talk about that. They regret. What do they regret? They regret convincing the people of Mount Kenya to vote for William Ruto. Is that what Ferdinand Waititu is trying to tell us? Because personally, I think he should be kicked out from politics completely for having misled the people of Mount Kenya. So perhaps if you watch this video and not subscribe, take 1 second and subscribe, like this video. Till you catch up again, stay safe and stay blessed.